Welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn about cookies. So if you're not already aware of what a cookie is, let me explain that first. So a cookie is basically this small bit of information that websites store on a user's computer or their browser. That's why you must have seen in your browsers, there's a thing in your settings, delete cookie or clear cookie. So basically what happens is, websites, for their convenience of operation, they store some pieces of information about the user, that is you, onto your computer. One simple example is, say if you have used Book My Show for booking movie tickets, what they do is they store some cookies on your browser, and one of the information that they store is the location from which you are accessing the website. So whenever you access the website again, they just access the cookie that was being set for the first time, and they puts the location, they update the location accordingly. So that is what we are going to do. We are going to see a simple demonstration of using a cookie in PHP. Let's start. So we are back in Sublime Text. For this particular demonstration, we are creating a new file and saving it as cookie demo.php. Okay, so this is a very simple demonstration. What we are going to do is, we are going to create a simple cookie which will store information, like say we are just going to save the location. Okay, so let's create a PHP file, and setting up a cookie is fairly simple. What you do is, we use a function called set cookie. Inside over here, we are going to provide three arguments. The first one is the name of the cookie, that is location. In the second argument, you are going to provide the value for the cookie, say Kolkata. And in the third part, you actually provide the time duration for which the cookie will be active on the user's computer. After that, the browser will automatically delete the cookie. So this can be done using the time function. So let's take $time, a variable which is equal to the time function. Okay, so this will basically give the current time in seconds. Okay, we have done this in a previous video. This will give us the timestamp, the color time, current time in seconds. So now what we have to do is, we'll have to just put $time plus the time for which we want to activate the cookie. We want the cookie to be activated. So it can be 1 minute, 1 hour, 1 day, or 1 year. Okay, but it has to be in seconds. So for now, we are setting this cookie for 1 minute. Okay, this is what basically is done to set a cookie, and we'll just echo out cookie is set. Okay, let's save this, and now we are just going to create a new file, save it as view cookie.php, and we'll simply just open the PHP tags, and we'll just echo out the cookie. To echo out the cookie, we use a similar way of similar syntax to that of session, and we'll just write the name of the cookie, that is location. That's it. Let's save it. So let's go to the browser and let's type localhost php demo, and let's first view cookie. So it gives nothing. Okay, it's, in fact, it says undefined index location. Okay, now let's go back to the browser and let's type the name of the file was cookie underscore demo. Okay, and it says cookie is set. Now let's go back and replace the file name with view cookie, and it says Kolkata. Now if you'll wait for like 60 seconds, what will happen is the cookie will expire. Okay, so this is how you actually set a cookie. What you do is, you call the function set cookie, and you provide three arguments, that is location, Kolkata is the value, and the time duration for which the cookie has to be active. And once you are done with that, this is how you call the cookie. You use a similar terminology or similar syntax like dollar underscore session. Okay, so let's see if the cookie has expired or not. Still active. Anyways, you can just check it on your browser. Okay.